everyone, and welcome to a work log for my 2014 Batgirl cave. Woo, so fancy. So as you notice, it's already done. Funny story, so I recorded the entire process, and then I went back to edit everything together, and I realized that all of the sewing footage was completely gone. So what I'm going to do is give you a quick explanation of the sewing, and then I'll show you the fancy stuff, like putting in the snaps and all that jazz. Also, cool, Fitbit, got it for Christmas. So to get started, I have my fabric here, and I used a two-way stretch pleather. It's nice and leather looking on the outside, and then it's just normal spandex on the inside. And then a spandex moleskin, because it's really, really thick, and it's also stretchy and it drapes nicely. So I used the moleskin for the liner and the stretch pleather for the outside part of the cape. Next part was drafting my pattern, and I just drew out the general shape of the cape and included measurements. And this whole part, this whole side, was cut on the fold. So in terms of the pattern, you can see this is where the neck goes, these go over the shoulder, and then you have the points. And you can do as many points as you want. I usually stick with 5 for Batgirl capes, just because it generally looks a little crowded with too many more than that, and less than that just looks awkward. So I've got 1, and then this becomes 2 and 3, and then you have 4 and 5. If you can imagine this folded out. So the cape is basically made of 2 pieces of fabric that are sewn together, and I cut out 1 of these in black on the fold and then 1 of them in yellow on the fold. Once I have my 2 pieces of fabric, I sewed them together right sides facing each other. So that would be like this shiny side on the inside and then this facing the inside. Imagine that these are nice cut out pieces of fabric, woohoo! And I sewed them together with this shiny side facing the spandex moleskin. Spandex moleskin doesn't really have too much of a right side, wrong side. There's one that's a little fuzzier. You can't really see it on the camera, but trust me, this side's a little fuzzier, and this one has more of the spandex texture to it. But again, doesn't really matter. You can't really tell a difference. So I sewed all the way along the outer seams with the right sides facing together, and then I left this little section open. You can see it's a little janky there because I'm an expert seamstress, but I left this little part open and then I turned the cape right side out. And at that point, when it's turned right side out, it's very bubbly, like the sides like to stick up and it shifts in and out of place, but this problem is solved by top stitching. And top stitching is this really super fancy technique, not really at all, and you just go along the seam, stitching it flat. And that holds the two sides together properly. So I top stitched around the entire cape, and then I folded these 2 raw seams inside, and then top stitched along there as well. And quick note, before I sealed the top hole, I do want to mention that I added BBs to the bottom of the points. BB pellets, BB gun bullets, whatever you want to call them, BB weight. And this adds a little bit of weight to each of the points so that the cape holds its shape and drapes really nicely when it is hanging off my shoulders. Anyway, I hope that part made sense. I wish I could have showed it to you, but like I mentioned, the footage was mysteriously gone. I don't know where it went. It was on my memory card, and I put the card in the computer, and then it was not there. And no matter what I did, I could not find it again. You didn't get to see it sewn, but I hope the explanation helped. Now, let's see the snaps.
I used heavy-duty snaps from Joanne Fabrics along with their matching plier tool, which is basically necessary to apply these. It's pretty straightforward, just follow the instructions that come with the pliers. First, I marked the spots for the snaps on the jacket and cut tiny holes, and then I put the bottom half of the snaps in the plier tool and threaded them through the holes. After that, it's hammer time! That was a terrible joke, so feel free to unsubscribe just for that. It's helpful if you have something really sturdy to brace the pliers against. I used an anvil. Once one snap is in, congratulations, you only have to do that 7 more times. Woohoo, the snaps are almost done. Only one problem, they need to be yellow. So now it's time to paint them. I just used basic acrylic paint that matched the yellow spandex, and it was super simple. And there, the hard part is over and the cape is finished. Wow, so lovely. The snaps are fully functional, so the cape can be taken on and off just like Batgirl's in the comic. This is really handy because then I can take the cape off and wear her jacket on a daily basis. Now it's time to suit up and show those creeps that Batgirl of Burnside is back in action.